Hello, my name's Emma Kennedy, and this is my next book, I Left My Tent in San Francisco, and it's the follow-up to The Tent, The Bucket and Me. And this book is set in 1989 and is about my disastrous attempt to try and cross America. I'd gone to America immediately after I finished at university. I thought to make my fortune and come back with my pocket stuffed with gold. Rather than finding my fortune, I rather found myself at the other end of the scale, absolutely penniless and impoverished and in all sorts of terrible dire straits. And this book is the story of how I did that. Now, I've been given a rucksack of things here. And I don't actually know what's in here, but apparently it's going to remind me of things that happen in the book. So I'm going to open it up and we'll go, Now, this is an ice cube tray. When I was in San Francisco, there was a friend of mine called Joplin who had a proper job. And I was slightly in awe of her. She had beige court shoes and everything. It was amazing. And she invited me over to her house for cocktails one evening. And I thought, swit-swoo, get me. I'm making gin and tonics in a swanky apartment in San Francisco. And but I was talking as I was making them. And I sort of reached into her freezer compartment and pulled out an ice cube tray. And just sort of nonchalantly banged it and tossed the ice cubes in the drinks and then merrily handed them out on a tray. And suddenly my friend Dee, my best friend that I went with, sort of looked down into her glass. She said, have you got a like funny ice cube tray or something? And everyone looked down and everybody had frozen mice fetuses bouncing in their gin and tonics because my friend Joplin had a snake called Sebastian and she used to feed, you know, mice fetuses to it and she kept them in her ice cube tray. This is a McDonald's box. So we had been trying for about 2 months to get a job. Failed at every point. At one point we'd gone into a fish and chip shop. I was ecstatic that we'd seen a fish and chip shop. It actually said English fish and chip shop. And I thought, there's no way that they're not going to want two English people to work in a fish and chip shop. We know everything about fish and chips. And the woman said, oh, this is terrible because I had two vacancies, but I just gave them away the previous day. The previous day. And this is after we've been looking for a job for 2 months. And we were downcast, absolutely downcast. And she had this bowl of fortune cookies next to the till, and she gave us two. And I handed one to my friend Dee, and she opened it, and it said, you know, something like, you've got the constitution of an ox, which she did. To be fair, she did. And then I opened up my one, and it said, bad luck and misfortune will haunt you for all eternity. Anyway, after that, we tried everything. We kept trying to get a job, couldn't get one. And our last port of call was to go and try and get a job in McDonald's in San Francisco. It was our last hope. We had gone to America, bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, full of hope and glory. And here we were at McDonald's trying to get a job. Guess what? Didn't get it. Oh, it's the fortune cookie. I've told you that story already, but just to reiterate what my fortune cookie said, bad luck and misfortune will haunt you for all eternity. Not a day, not a week, all eternity. Let's see what this one says, see if it's an improvement. Oh, this one says the opportunity to show your leadership will soon be here. Well, take my lid, go and buy my book.